ready? Start. The learned solicitor journal then challenged the orders of the division bench of the High Court on the ground of violation of the principles of natural justice. It was contended that while the High Court had concluded the hearing and reserved judgment on 20th July 2011 by order dated 12th October 2011, it directed the Speaker to place on record the status of the proceedings relating to the disqualification petitions. Although the same were duly filed without giving the parties further opportunity of hearing with regard to the said records, the division bench directed the matter to be listed for further consideration on 19th December 2011. It was submitted that though the bench did not assemble on 19th December 2011, the division bench delivered the impugned judgment on 20th December 2011 without any further opportunity of hearing to the parties. The learned solicitor journal submitted that the procedure adopted was contrary to the law laid down in another case wherein it was stated as under. In view of the limited scope of judicial review that is available on account of the finality clause in paragraph 6 and also having regard to the constitutional entendment and the status of the repository of the adjudicatory power, Speaker Chairman, judicial review cannot be available at a stage prior to the making of a decision by the Speaker Chairman, and a quick time action would not be permissible, nor would interference be permissible at an in-between stage of the proceedings. Exception will, however, have to be made in respect of cases where disqualification or suspension is imposed during the pendency of the proceedings, and such disqualification or suspension is likely to have grave, immediate and irreversible repercussions and consequences. The learned solicitor journal sought to re-emphasize the fact that the present case is not a case involving disqualification or suspension of a member of the House by the Speaker during the pendency of the proceedings, but relates to disqualification proceedings pending before the Speaker which were not being deposed off for one reason or the other. It was submitted that the fact that the Speaker had not finalized the disqualification petitions for almost a period of 2 years could not and did not vest the High Court with power to usurp the jurisdiction of the Speaker and to pass interim orders. The learned solicitor journal lastly urged that the single most important error in the impugnment judgment is that it sought to foreclose the right of the Speaker to decide the disqualification petitions under paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule. The said decision was also wrong, since the division bench chose to follow judgments which related to the concept of split under paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule, which today stands deleted therefrom. The learned solicitor journal submitted that there was a clear difference between matters relating to the erstwhile paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule and paragraph 4 thereof. While paragraph 3 of the 10th schedule required proof of two splits, paragraph 4 requires proof of only one deemed merger. The learned solicitor journal submitted that there was no concept of deemed split in paragraph 3. It was submitted that paragraph 4 is meant only as a defense to a petition for disqualification, and the same would succeed or fail depending on whether there was a deemed merger or not. It was further submitted that under paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule, the Speaker was not the deciding authority on whether a merger of two political parties had taken place or not. It was urged that the expression used in paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule for the purpose of paragraph 4 clearly indicates that the deeming provision is not in addition to but for the purpose of paragraph 4, which is entirely different from the scheme of paragraph 3, which uses the expression and thereby indicating that a split takes place only if there is a split in the original political party and at least one third of the members of the legislature party also joined in. It was further submitted that the use of the expression if and only if in paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule is to reemphasize the fact that the Speaker cannot decide whether merger of the original party had taken place, as he is only required to decide whether merger was a defense in a disqualification petition filed under paragraph 6 of the 10th schedule. The Learned Solicitor Journal then urged that the submission advanced on behalf of the respondent number 1, that in view of the delay by the Speaker in disposing of the disqualification petitions, this court should decide the same was wholly misconceived, since it presupposes the vesting of power to decide such a question on the court, though the same is clearly vested in the Speaker. Even otherwise, the most that could be done by this court would be to dismiss the special leave petition.